Welcome to episode 576, Zhang Yi Ming, the first AI self-made billionaire in the world from China. This is an outline of episode 576. There are three reasons we study Zhang Yi Ming. First, he's the first AI self-made billionaire in the world. Second, he founded ByteDance in 2012. And now Toutiao is the most popular content app in the world, with 1 billion users worldwide. Third, he's only 36. Let us meet Zhang Yi Ming.
基本上早上兴趣里面开始讨论工作了，很多时候可能国际上一些大事不如身边社区的事情。我叫张一鸣，从小就是信息的重度阅读者，并且从小也喜欢计算机。那毕业之后呢，我来了北京，一直在互联网这个方面创业。我一直想做有意识、有挑战的东西。
He was born in Longyan City, Fujian Province in China in 1983. In 2005, he graduated from Nankai University with a degree in software engineering. He was 22. He also got married, but I couldn't find a picture of his wife. He's pretty secretive. In the next 5 years, he had five jobs, including one working for Microsoft China. In 2010, he had his own startup, 99fang.com, which is a real estate listing website. In 2012, at the age of 29, Zhang Yiming was the first in the world to use artificial intelligence to found his company, ByteDance.
因为中国的这个人才的密集度、基础设施，就是带宽啊、网络的基础设施、用户的密集度、用户的消费能力、就市场的成熟度都很高了，所以创办了今日头条这家公司。His
first product or app is called Toutiao, meaning headlines in English. It's a kind of news feed or news aggregator.
Created content, but they didn't just publish it there so people could find it, they pushed it in a personalized way to their users. Is that they were the first media app in the world that really used machine learning and artificial intelligence to understand the needs and behavior of their users. And this allowed them to personalize all the content towards their users. So they push messages in a very personalized way and people love it. And because of that, people become addicted to this platform. To give you an idea, an average Chinese user of Toutiao is spending 74 minutes per day on this channel. This is huge. If you compare that with Facebook, that's 50% more time than Facebook, 74 minutes a day. And then if you look at their monetization, this is also extremely impressive. Look at this graph. The small growing lines of those companies on the bottom, those are the first four years of monetization of companies like Facebook and LinkedIn and Tencent. I mean, these are now the biggest technology companies in the world. And if you compare that with the growth of monetization of Toutiao, it is crazy, that difference. Only
His second big hit after Toutiao is TikTok. Now TikTok has 1 billion downloads.
In the early stage of its international expansion, TikTok, its most popular app abroad, has reached over a billion downloads, with about 25% from India and 9% from the US.
ByteDance is the first Chinese internet company to expand overseas in its first 3 years of existence.
Its apps are for everything, from news aggregation and short videos to online education.
Unlike other Chinese companies, it was thinking of expanding overseas relatively early on. The founder, Yiming, was already talking about acquisitions and hiring from overseas places like the US and Europe just 2.5 to 3 years into his company's lifespan.
7 years, the company has evolved into a multifaceted empire, spanning about a dozen products available in 150 markets and 75 different languages. Success abroad has been partly achieved through smart acquisitions and strategic expansions. ByteDance brought karaoke-style video app Musical.ly in late 2017. Musical.ly was already very popular for teens and younger millennials in the US. The company then merged Musical.ly in
In 2019, Zhang Yiming, the 26-year-old solo founder of ByteDance, has a net worth of $16.2 billion. His company, ByteDance, is the world's most valuable unicorn, with a valuation of $75 billion. That's according to investment by SoftBank of Japan and also Sequoia Capital of China. Lastly, a bit of interesting controversy from the Chinese government.
Under a lot of pressure in mainland China. They had a couple of government complications. So some of their platforms were forced to exit the market. Some of their platforms were paused and were not allowed to be refreshed because the content was sometimes going too viral and sometimes did not quite fit in line with government, let's say, regulations and stuff like that. So they were on the naughty book several times last year and this year, but they're cleaning up their act. And actually, according to Douyin team, some of the mainland China government accounts are the most popular accounts on the platform. So for example, China Army has a Douyin account where they're publishing videos of.
What have I learned today? Two things. First, Zhang is the first in the world to build an internet company based on artificial intelligence back in 2012. Second, his company ByteDance is also the first Chinese internet company to successfully expand it overseas in his first 3 years of existence. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and leave your questions and comments below. My next video will be Zhang Yiming 10 Lessons. Wishing everyone peace and prosperity.